Alright guys, kembali lagi bersama dengan saya Adini dalam isu kita hari ini, iaitu berkenaan dengan Undi 18. Masih lagi dengan Cik Afah kita. Tadi Cik Afah cakap one step at a time. Maksudnya kita akan make sure yang Undi 18 ni dilaksanakan terlebih dahulu, baru kita akan fikir tentang macam mana suasana politik dekat kampus, adakah akta hasutan AUKU ni akan dimasukkan, dan mungkin cadangan untuk make sure yang belia remaja kita yang berumur 18 tahun ni lebih berpengetahuan dan berminat dalam politik. So apa-apa pun bermula dengan pelaksanaan Undi 18 dulu, baru kita akan fikir pasal step-step yang lain. So sekarang ni kita nak move dengan next question pula. Ada kajian menunjukkan 70% anak muda tak ambil kisah langsung pasal politik ni. Ada tak cara untuk galakkan mereka supaya lebih berpengetahuan dalam politik dan bersedia untuk mengundi seawal usia 18 tahun?
Okay, thank you Dini for mentioning that research. We just heard about it juga hari ni. And then research tu dilakukan oleh Kelab Bunga Raya, right? So what I been reading and finding out, the research tu dia fokus dekat social media, on a Facebook poll. And then ada 2,000 respondent. And then which of most of them were from Kelab Bunga Raya themselves. So saya rasa itu tidak mewakili seluruh kumpulan belia yang kita sedang perjuangkan sebagai undi 18. I'm not saying it is not relevant, I'm not saying that number is incorrect, but what I'm saying is it does not show the whole picture. So I take it as a number, it is statistic, saya terima statistik itu. Saya tak rasa benda itu palsu, tapi saya rasa benda itu tak menunjukkan gambar yang seluruh,
the whole belia.
Yeah, so dia tak adil kalau nak kita kata okay, based on penyelidikan ini yang hanya berlaku untuk 3 hari, 2,000 respondent, and most of which is from KBR, automatically we letak terus all the beliers in Malaysia kata tak nak. When we say 70%, dia tak melambangkan semua orang. Dia hanya melambangkan sekumpulan sahaja. Itu yang kami rasa penting. Sekarang kami ingin menyuarakan ataupun menegakkan hak belia-belia di mana you dah ada tanggungjawab sebagai seorang dewasa, tapi benda pelik ni you tak boleh mengundi. So kami rasa benda tu macam tak adil. But again, because of the current research yang baru berlaku hari ni juga, MSGA, Malaysian Student Global Alliance, mereka sedang lakukan penyelidikan yang baru in the efforts of it to really, bukanlah counter, but try to show a bigger picture. MSGA, Malaysian Student Global Alliance, and where they involve all the students, Malaysian students from overseas, as well as the local students. Again, statistic ni we have to be careful, but I'm not saying they're wrong. But thank you for pointing it out so I can clear up the air. A lot of people are using this penyelidikan as benchmark
sebagai tentangan.
That's what you're saying it lah.
Tak boleh ni nak buat benda ni. Sebab the 70% mengatakan okay, belia tak setuju, belia tak ready. Okay. Benda ni memang tak boleh diguna pakai lah maksudnya.
Boleh guna pakai to a certain extent, tapi nak terus melambangkan everybody saying no, I don't think it's fair for both parties lah.
Apa yang bakal berlaku dalam few weeks ni supaya usul ni disokong? I mean The whole process. Siapa yang akan bentangkan pembicaraan tu macam mana? Maybe you can share with us.
So with that, right now our main objective is the final push. So you also have the political part. You jumpa, you have all the discussions, ada perjumpaan, ada agreement. And then there's also the public part. The nak mendapatkan sokongan rakyat. So melalui social media, melalui Facebook, Twitter, Instagram. So benda-benda tu kami rasa dua-dua penting. It's not just kalau tukar perlembagaan tak bermaksud kita tak perlu mendapatkan pendapat rakyat. But again, if we're talking about step by step process, it's all very dynamic. So even right now, Tarma, like the co-founder, and Kira, they're all like, oh, there's a meeting here, there's a meeting there. So mereka sedang cuba untuk jumpa seramai mungkin. I can say it's a dynamic process. Saya tak boleh nak terus bagi set. Macam mana, macam mana
nak share dia punya proses tu
one by one tu, saya rasa saya pun
agak susah.
Yes.
So but there is something is going
something
on
is
lah
going
sekarang
on.
Ni.
Right now, every day, everybody's updating. Masing-masing tengah making a huge effort. Sebab lagi sikit-sikit lagi nak habis. It's been years. Hmm. And now, I suddenly, diorang kata lagi sebulan. Rasa macam, tak percaya pun ada juga.
Finally, it's coming to an end, kan?
Yes.
So, sekarang ni, it doesn't matter lah. Apa yang rakyat rasa, it doesn't matter. Sebab once the perlembagaan dah state what have to do, then rakyat just follow je lah. Kena abide the rules.
We're not trying to disregard rakyat. What we're trying to do is we, channel. It's very hard to know what the rakyat wants based on a Facebook poll. You know, but that's why we don't just look at meetings. Kita look at social media as well. We're trying to get as many people. Sebab not everybody is on Facebook. Some people are only on Twitter. Some people exclusively atas Instagram. So kita tengok age group juga, right? So setengah orang yang lebih berumur, mereka lebih gemar kat Facebook. Yang lebih muda gemar dekat Twitter. So benda tu, we are making an effort untuk dengar pendapat mereka. But right now we're doing our best.
We are focusing dekat itulah, dekat
perlembagaan tu. Sebab lagi sebulan je lagi. Tapi we still jumpa juga. We're trying to make an impact in social media.
Okay lah. Sekarang ni kita tengok dekat media masa, TV, whatever, kan? Nampak macam YB Said Saddiq je. Banyak berucap, banyak buat statement. How about menteri-menteri lain di belakang tabir tu? Adakah ini cuma tindakan solo daripada YB Said Saddiq? Ataupun sebenarnya dekat belakang tu ada lagi sokongan daripada menteri berkenaan dengan Undi 18 ni?
Okay, one thing about media that I've learned is that banyak benda dia tapis. Not everybody can be on media. They're not going to shoot every meeting that happens belakang pintu. Right. But one thing, kenapa Syed Saddiq, right, kenapa YB Youth and Sports jadi muka benda ni? Sebab dah lama YB belia. Right, so dia secara automatik menjadi orang yang memperjuangkan benda ni. Tapi kenapa muka dia je? Senang kata, I'm not going to say the media loves him, but I'm going to say that he is currently the one that everybody pays attention to. So setiap kali the media would look at him, but what you see on media, what you see on the news or on the video on TV, dia tak melambangkan semua orang. Dia hanya melambangkan seorang saja. But he tak akan sampai sini kalau without the past efforts of everybody else involved.
So that's mean dekat behind pun sebenarnya
ada ramai lagi
yang support dia, yang buat kerja sama-sama. So doesn't mean yang dia bergerak solo.
Dia tak akan bergerak solo. I don't think, no matter how high you are, my apologies, even though you're a prime minister or you're a menteri or you're a student, you always require help. You can start something yourself, tapi to really get the ball rolling, you need bantuan semua orang. So people, orang akan ingat dia seorang je perjuangkan ni sebab muka dia je.
Muka dia je kat
muka
media,
dia
of
je.
Course.
Yeah, but it really isn't just him. I believe, and even we ourselves have met other people, there's a whole group of them. It's just that tak semua akan be in the media as much as he is. I'm not saying it's bad. Thank you so much for the publicity. But if you're going to say that apa, YB tu seorang saja yang berjuangkan, I feel like it is misinterpreted by the media. Yes, media has a way of only showing the good parts.
Alright. Okay, I think one final question, please. Do you think PH, the Pakatan Harapan, is doing good enough, especially pasal isu ni? Sebab benda ni memang tertakluk dalam diorang punya manifesto, kan?
Yes.
So adakah anda rasa yang PH ni dah buat yang terbaik?
I feel like they are. Kita ada tarikh, kan? Next month. That's, to me, that's significant because, you know, with politics, with business deals, orang akan cakap macam ni, oh, nanti kita fikir. Oh, nanti kita cakap. Tapi tak akan ada benda tetap, tak akan ada tarikh. It's always something that we'll think about it later, but you never do. But right now, it's moving. The ball is moving. The momentum dah ada. And dah sekarang, it's, there's a date. It is solid. Pretty much, I feel like we're very grateful with the support and we're hoping for the best.
Alright, okay. That's it guys. Itu je jawapan daripada Cik Afaf Ismail kita berkenaan dengan isu undi 18 yang bakal ditentukan dalam a few weeks lagi sama ada berjaya ataupun tidak kita menggerakkan belia yang berumur 18 tahun ini supaya mengundi. Okay, thank you Cik Afaf.
Thank you
for
Dini.
Today's interview. Dan korang di My Campus Radio. Lepas ni korang boleh tengok dekat My Campus TV. Apa pula pendapat anak muda berkenaan dengan undi 18 ini? Ha, so right now kita stop dekat sini dulu. Kita jumpa lagi di next session, next slot, next issue. Ini dia My Campus Radio. Jom berubah bersama.